In our last video, we set up our form to get ready for our doctor's visit application. We gathered patient info while they sit in their waiting room, and we even organized it well in our entry manager. Today, let's complete the application by creating a view and putting it on a page. Here's where we left off, in the entry manager. I added a couple more entries as an example, and we used the screen options to only show what a tech would need to see. They can go in and edit the entry to add a time and notes, or change things like urgency. Let's add a view. Go to your application and add an item. Choose a view, and then choose a grid view. Select our doctor's visit form as our data source. It'll automatically generate a name, and that works for me, so we'll use it. Okay, so we're in the grid designer. Let's create the layout. I have an idea for what I want the doctor to be able to see on this view. I want space for the patient name, then the appointment time, and the urgency. In the bottom large area, I want staff notes, and then on the right, I want all their medical conditions and medications. Okay, let's assign those fields to each grid section. It's super easy. Just click the grid, and then click the field. We'll do that for each grid area. And you can put more than one thing in each area. You can even use conditional logic. For example, I won't display anything for medications unless they selected yes on the toggle field that asked if they were taking any. Okay, so we designed our view. When we click Update View, it looks like this. And this will work fine. I'm going to spend just a little time designing it so it looks slightly nicer. It won't look amazing. You can style your stuff however you want. I just want to get this application built. I'm going to change the font size of the top three grid spaces so they're easier to read. I also went in and added some padding and added a rounded border to the staff notes part. Great. Update to save and then go to your applications again. This time, add a page. I'll name it Patients, and then on that page, add your Formidable View block. Let's check it out. There it is. I might want to pretty it up a little more, but imagine a doctor seeing this on a monitor so they can quickly see what patient is next and what they need or if they need to move things around. Would actually implementing this violate HIPAA laws? Almost certainly. But that's not the point of this video. The point is to get you thinking about how you can build applications quickly and easily for your own needs. What about customer support screens or IT service tickets? There is so much you can do with Formidable. Subscribe for more form and application building tips, and I'll see you next time.